Hello, I'm Natalia Lunata, a fiber artist and your Canadian guide to the vibrant world of textile art and boundless creativity. In the previous video, I showed you how to felt classic wool cords. In this video, I will teach you how to make unique cords that can serve as decorations in their own right. As always, you'll need a bowl of room temperature water, soap, a spray bottle with water, bubble wrap on the table, a rubber or bamboo mat, and a cotton towel for the work. To create multi-layered felt cords, we need wool in several colors. It's best if the colors are contrasting. In this case, I am using merino wool of 21-25 microns in comb top form, but you can use wool from any sheep breed and different fineness depending on your project. The felting method remains the same as for regular cords. The trick lies in the wool layout. Here, I'm using three colors of wool. Each piece of comb top should be 10% longer than the desired length of the finished felted cord. For the outer layer, I stretch the wool widthwise, laying perpendicular thin layers of wool of the same color across the brown comb top. This ensures the outer layer is denser and prevents fibers of other colors from showing through. Next, take the wool of the second color, in my case yellow, using 1/3 less than the outer layer wool. Stretch it widthwise and lay it in the middle of the outer color wool. Then place a small strand of wool for the center. I am using red. Place it in the center and roll it up. The red will be inside, surrounded by yellow, and the outermost layer will be dark brown wool. Now roll this neat little wool roll. If you're unsure of your skills, you can lightly needle felt the outer part, as sometimes done with wool beads. However, if you work carefully with your hands, you can felt it without any damage. So, we roll the wool and continue the process. First, gently dry felt the roll on a ribbed surface, then lightly spray the table surface with water to continue felting. Start by felting the wool roll on the wet table surface, then soap your hands thoroughly and continue rolling the wool roll with soapy hands on the table to ensure the wool fibers bind and the roll doesn't fall apart. Remember, the movements should be very gentle and light. Carefully roll the wool without pressing too hard. You will need to soap your hands several times to ensure the soapy solution penetrates all the wool. Continue felting the wool on the table, moving your hands from the middle of the cord to the ends, and with back and forth motions along the table, from you and towards you. Make very light movements, avoiding pressing the roll into a flat strip. Since this cord will be multi-layered, the felting technique itself doesn't change. We carefully, initially without pressure, then gradually increasing it, roll the wool on the table surface, thereby gradually compacting it. While I am felting this cord, let me share a little secret. To achieve a more interesting and textured cross-section, you can use various yarns or even yarn scraps or pieces of silk fabric for the core, which in this case is red. These materials will felt into the center of the cord and the wool will secure them, creating a unique and interesting effect at the cross-section. By the way, this multi-layered felting technique can be used to create extra strong handles for bags. You can place a cotton cord inside the outer wool layer and felt it, matching the wool you are using for the bag. These bag handles will be incredibly sturdy and reliable. Such reinforced handles with a cotton cord inside should be sewn onto bags rather than felted directly, allowing them to bear a significant load. Although well-felted cords are already very strong and durable. Continue felting the cord. As with regular cords, and especially with multi-layered ones, patience is key. If you need to make several cords, you can prepare the pieces in advance, slightly pre-felting them in the initial stages without the mat, and then felt the required number of cords together in the mat. 1, 2, 3, 5, as many as you need. This way you can prepare cords for different projects simultaneously without them tangling. This approach saves time since felting 3 or 5 cords together is quicker than felting each one separately. You can use felted cords for various felting projects, to decorate surfaces, or to create unique jewelry, dreadlocks, pom-poms, and even faux fur. All of this can be beautifully crafted from felted cords. Of course, this takes time, but with experience, you will make these cords faster and faster. Moreover, this activity can be combined with watching a movie or series or listening to an audiobook. Pay special attention to your hand movements during felting, especially when felting in the mat. Keep moving your hands from the middle to the ends and vice versa to ensure the cord felts evenly along its entire length. The density of the finished cord should match the purpose and functionality of your project. If you need dreadlocks or laces, you can stop when the cords are still soft. If you need cords for jewelry, felt them more thoroughly. For this, as with felting any wool item, we use familiar methods: kneading the cord like dough, rolling it like a snowball, tapping it on the table, or additionally felting on a textured surface. All these are well-known techniques, and we use them to achieve the desired firmness and density of the felted cord. But remember, the primary technique for felting cords is rolling the wool roll on the table surface. Don't skimp on time and effort for this. Understanding that this work will take time, plan it so you can accomplish as much as possible in one session. Many of my colleagues do breathing exercises, leg workouts, walk in place, or listen to something while felting cords, making the most of their time. If the cord is not fully felted at this stage, you'll realize it when rinsing out the soap, as it will remain loose and will require additional felting. Hence, it's better to do the job thoroughly from the start. So, we've reached the final stage. When the cord is fully felted, don't forget to rinse it thoroughly in room temperature water. If you want additional shrinkage, alternate rinsing in hot and cold water. The most important thing is to remove all soap residues from the finished cord. Now, let me show you why we layered the wool. I am making the cut. You can make a cross-sectional or diagonal cut, depending on what you intend to create from this cord. You can make beautiful beads this way. By coating the cut ends with clear acrylic varnish, you can make lovely buttons for your felted items. You can create unique jewelry. Additionally, you can make small cuts on the cord surface to create a cord with an unusual texture and colorful inserts. This theme offers nearly limitless creative possibilities. It's all up to your imagination. I wish you new creative ideas and plenty of free time for your favorite hobby. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe to my channel. Ask questions in the comments and share the link with your friends. See you at the next masterclass.